Oh my gosh, you guys, freaking March, we're in March. February flew out the door. I don't even know where we're at right now, but that month went by really fast. So here to do my monthly favorites for February. And I don't have that much stuff. A lot of it is skincare though, which I'm kind of happy about because I love skincare products. So we're just gonna jump right into it. The first thing I have on here, which I'm really excited about actually, is from L'Oreal, and it's their new Boost It High Lift Creation Spray. I don't even know why they put, I guess because you can create some big old hair, but I love this stuff. I barely got this like a week ago, but I had to include it because I'm obsessed. So, oh my gosh, it's amazing. And I've never had a hairspray give me that much volume, but this one, it really does. You just, especially like with curled hair, I just spray it in there and like lift up my hair a little bit and like, you know, poof it out. And it just like, I don't know, it makes it look just fuller. And it's especially for me, I really like to use it when I put my hair in a ponytail and I curl it on those days where I'm lazy. I will spray this at the beginning of the ponytail, and it'll make it like, you know, that Barbie, that nice Barbie ponytail. So I really love this stuff, obsessed. And it's like, what, like $4.99. So that's awesome. Next thing I have is the Mario Badescu, is that what it is? I don't know. It's the acne facial cleanser. And a funny story, I went into Ulta to get, I believe, I don't know what it's called, but it's the one that actually foams up and lathers. And I thought it was this one, but I think this is their newest one. Oh my gosh, this actually has made a difference in my skin because I do break out. I don't know what it is, but I always like break out like over here. And they say that this area is hormonal. I don't know what's going on, but this definitely has helped maintain the breakouts and I'm obsessed. Like, I've only had this for maybe like 3 weeks, I want to say. Pretty much a month to 3 weeks. I've never used like that much cleanser so fast. So I use it at night and in the morning sometimes, but mostly at night. And it just like does wonders. I love this stuff. So got that. Next skincare thing is the Expert Sensitive. Okay, I don't know if that's in focus, but it's the Expert Sensitive Hydrating Eye Cream, and this is by Boots. I love this stuff, and I was in the market for an eye cream because, I don't know, I've just been noticing that my under eye area gets, like, really dry. I don't know what it is, but this has actually really helped that. I usually put this on, too, before I put on my concealer so that it's not all like dry and flaky and gross. So I really like this stuff a lot, and it's like, it's almost gone, and it's pretty reasonably priced. I think it's like $7.99. I got this at Target, so I've been loving that. Next thing I have is the Nivea Lip Butter in Raspberry Rose Kiss. I've actually seen this in a few other videos, but I love this stuff. So I will usually put this on at night before I go to sleep, and it just is like an, to me, I feel like it's like a lip mask. I don't know why, but every time I put it on at night and I wake up, my lips are so soft in the morning, and it just smells. Oh, I don't even know, I have to show it to you, but oh man, it smells like, okay, are you guys familiar with the candy Mamba? It's like a chewy candy. It's like Starburst, but not. It smells like that. Oh my gosh, smells so good. I just want to eat it. So I love this stuff. And last thing, this is a lotion, which is technically skincare. So this is by actually a brand that's not, it's not like a commercial brand or anything like that. But it's this Shea Lotion by the brand Clean Spa. And if you watched my What's in My Bag video, which I'll link down below, but I carry a little version of this in my purse at all times, so in case my hands get dry, wash my hands, I can always moisturize them, and I am obsessed. This is in the scent Ginger Tea, and I had to get the big one, so this is what I use to refill that little travel one I have, but it is awesome, and it's like, I have to like use it now. It's in the smell Ginger Tea, and it's just like a nice like spa smell. I don't even know how to describe it. It's just like, it has that like spa clean scent. I don't know, it just smells so good. I'm sorry guys, I can't describe it. But they have a bunch of different scents on their website. They're based out of Southern California, but you can order from their website. And I'll link it down below. But, obsessed, I love this. And I try to use it sparingly because I don't want to run out. Because I think I got this last summer and I'm like, ooh. I hate it when I get to like the halfway point of something I really like. I'm just always like, no, it's running out. But it's really not. I still have quite a bit, but I'm probably gonna have to refill this once it runs out. I only have a few makeup products. First thing I have, so this is pretty much has been a staple in the YouTube community for a while, but I finally got it after like pretty much a year, which I've been doing a lot lately, like stuff I've noted down to get. I barely have gotten like now after being exposed to the items and like knowing about it for months and months. I finally have gotten some of them. So this is the Ben Nye banana powder, and I love this stuff, and it's pretty cheap. I mean, not cheap quality, but it's pretty like nicely priced. This one was $10 and it's just the smaller version. I didn't want to get the big one because I didn't know if I was gonna like it, and I was like, well, at least if I don't like it, I'm not wasting a lot. So yeah, and I'm pretty sure you can find this anywhere online, but I love it. It like sets my concealer really well, obviously, but what I've also found is if my concealer ends up like, if it ends up looking like too bright and it's just like, you know, too glowy, then when I pop this out, it kind of like evens it out, and it's just like the shade is nice. So I love this stuff, and it's gonna take me, I mean, even though I got the small one, it's gonna take me a while to finish this. Next thing I have here is the Color Tattoo, and this is from their new collection, the Dare to Be Nude collection. I remembered. And this is in the color Nude Compliment, and I thought it was gonna be like Bad to the Bronze, which is the only color tattoo I have, but it really isn't, in my opinion. It's really like a nice taupey, it's like a grayish color, because the other one is more of a true bronze, like a brownish bronze. So that's it right there. But I love this, and if I'm just like quick on the go and I don't really want to do my eye makeup, then I will pop this on my lids and a little bit of mascara and I'm fine. So yeah, I've been like really liking Color Tattoos. I have another one, but this was my favorite color. So the next thing I have here is the Inglot gel liner, and I actually was really wanting to get this at IMATS, but they sold out, and then they said they were gonna get more, but then I came back and they're like, oh, wait an hour, and I just I forgot about it. So luckily I was in Vegas recently, and they do have a store in Caesar's Palace, the Forum Shops, I believe. And I even put like a reminder on my phone that week. I was like, don't forget to get the Inglot gel liner because I've heard such great things about it. And it is freaking amazing. Like, so creamy, and it's so black. Like, it's the blackest gel liner I've ever had. And I've been really into gel liners lately. I just feel like I like how matte they look when they dry, and I've been having an easier time with them with the brush. But I'm just gonna tap this a little bit. Oh my gosh, that's even, look, I just barely tapped. Oh, sorry, I'm not flipping you off, but I barely tapped it, and it's like, so, oh my gosh, barely tapped, and look how black that is. Like, it's amazing. So I'm gonna have to order online when I run out, but amazing. Like, this has become a holy grail, like gel liner. Not even gel, like I don't even consider it just in the category of gel, but just an eyeliner in general. Like, this is my favorite. And the last item I have are lip products, and these are the new Milani, let's see, what is it? Milani Power Lip Gloss Stains. These are awesome, and look at how cute they are. Like, the packaging is so small. The two colors I got are Mango Tango, because I've been really into corals lately, and then I also have a Raspberry Tart. And they're just like little glosses, but I don't even consider it a gloss because they're not too shiny, and the formula is really nice. It's almost like a liquid lipstick with a little bit more gloss in it. But you just twist it up. I'm not going to twist it because it's going to get all messy. But yeah, and then there's a little brush in there. But I'll twist it a little bit so I can do a swatch here. So that's Mango Tango right there. It's just a nice, like, deeper coral color. And I really like the consistency of these because it's not too thick. It doesn't feel like overbearing on your lips. Because I tend to feel that when I wear glosses. And then the other color I have here, just to show you, is the Raspberry Tarte. And I'm going to do a swatch right here. And this is just a really pretty, like, raspberry mauve-y color. Which really goes well with my lips because I'm darker skinned and my lips are pretty pigmented. So I like that color a lot. That's pretty much all I've got. I didn't really have too many things. And I don't want to feature like a lot of products because then I'll run out of what to talk about. That's all I've got for you guys. And the sun's going down, so I'm going to have to wrap it up here. But I hope you guys like this video, and go ahead and like and subscribe if you did. And I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.